subsidiary aligned system that was passed by the British. So I've written the heading subsidiary aligned system. Now what is subsidiary aligned system? That Lord Wellesley introduced the subsidiary aligned system. So who introduced subsidiary aligned system? It was introduced by Lord Cornwallis, who was the Governor General in 1786, right? So Lord Cornwallis introduced this system called subsidiary aligned system. And according to this system, what happened? Under this system, any Indian ruler whose security was threatened could seek help from and enter into an alliance with the British. The British would protect the ruler from any kind of attack. So, under this system, what was the agreement that was made by the British and the Indian ruler? That if any Indian ruler's life was in danger, if his life was threatened, then he could, then that Indian ruler could take help from the British and they can form an alliance. Alliance means they can form a group with the British, they can take help from the British, and the British would help the Indian ruler from any kind of attack. But in return, the Indian ruler, they also had to do something. What? The Indian ruler in return, they had to permanently keep and maintain the British troops in his or her state at his or her own cost. So here also you see the cunning cleverness of the British. The British, they made this subsidiary alliance system, but here also they got benefited because they were very cunning and they used the Indian people, they used all the Indian rulers as their puppet. So you see that they said that they will protect the Indian rulers from any kind of attack, but in return the Indian ruler had to maintain the British army and to keep a British army, any army. If you want to keep or if you want to maintain an army, you have to spend money a lot. So the Indian rulers, they had to spend a lot of money. So they had to spend a lot of money to keep this British army. So this was the agreement, that you have to keep and maintain British army at your own cost. And in return, I will protect you. The British said, I will protect you from any kind of danger. So the Indian ruler, and another thing was also written in the agreement under this subsidiary alliance system, that the Indian ruler could not form an alliance with any other power or declare war with any power without the permission of the British. So also there was one more point added in that subsystem, that the Indian rulers, they were not allowed to form a group with any other power other than the British, because if they formed group, they formed an alliance with another power, then the British would be in problem. They would face, they would not get all the advantage. So to keep the Indian rulers in their hand, they said that you will not form any alliance with any other power. Even if you want to form, you have to take permission. So that's how the British tried to, that's how the British controlled the Indian rulers and took all the powers and control in their hands by passing this subsidiary alliance system. And so after signing this system, after signing this agreement, the Indian rulers had to face a lot of problem, because they were not getting any kind of benefit from this system. All the benefits, everything the British got. So the subsidiary alliance was not at all beneficial to Indian rulers. As I said, the subsidiary alliance proved beneficial only for the British, because the rulers who accepted this system, they were under the British rule, they were under the British control, and they had to follow whatever the British said to them. On the other hand, the British took advantage of that situation. They acquired large territories as part of the subsidiary payment. So you see that slowly how the British, they were expanding their territory. So after signing this agreement, after signing this subsidiary alliance system, the British took what? They acquired large territories. They told the Indian rulers that since I have provided you this system, I have given this system to you, and I am protecting you from any kind of danger, in return you have to give give me payment for this system. And what kind of payment they wanted? They wanted payment not in form of cash, but they wanted large territories. So they expanded their territories. This is how they expanded their territories, and they took all the Indian territories as subsidiary payment. And this is how the British slowly gained more power, and it helped the company, that is the English East India Company, to become the supreme power in India. And that is how the English East India Company, the British, became more powerful, the supreme power in India, and they started ruling India for a long time. And they actually ruled India for a long time until and unless we got independence, that is November 1947. So this was subsidiary alliance system. Now let us move to another portion of this chapter, that is the British and the Marathas. Now who were the Marathas? The Marathas controlled most of the western and central India. So India, it's a very big country, so there are different parts in India, and those parts are controlled by different religions, different people, so different states. So Maratha controlled the western and central India. It was controlled by the Marathas. Now Maratha consists of 5 independent states, and these 5 independent states you have to learn it by heart. Now what are the 5 independent states that the Maratha Empire consists of? So underline the Peshwas of Pune, the Gaikwads of Baroda, the Bhosles of Nagpur, the Sindhias of Gwalior, and the Holkars of Indore. So these are the 5 independent states of Marathas. So please learn this answer. What are the 5 independent states of Marathas? You have to learn it along with spelling. That Peshwas of Pune, Gaikwads of Baroda, Bhosles of Nagpur, Sindhias of Gwalior, and the Holkars of Indore. So they were the major rivals of the British. So we find another rival group. Obviously, all were rivals at that point of time against the British, because the British did not treat the Indian people properly. They treated them cruelly, and so all were against the British. So this one of the most major powerful rivals was the Marathas. These 5 states were the major rivals of the British. So if the question comes, who were the major rivals of British? The major rivals of British were the 5 independent states that comes under Marathas. So they fought bravely with the British in the Anglo-Maratha War. So after that, one war took place that is known as Anglo-Maratha War, but they were also defeated. It took the British 43 years and 3 wars to bring the Marathas under the control. So you see that all the cities, all the states were slowly coming under the control of the British. The British waged a lot of war. First, the Mysore War took place. It took 32 years to control the Mysore, and it took 32 years and 4 wars to take Mysore under the control of the British. In the same way, the British took the Marathas under their control, but it took how many years? It took 43 years. So you can understand they were so powerful. Like the Mysore, these Marathas were also powerful, and it took 43 years. 43 years and how many wars? 3 wars. 43 years and 3 wars took place to take the Marathas under the British control. And so this is how slowly the Marathas powers in North India, South India, everything was coming under the control of the British, and the British were expanding their territories. So again, I will finish up to this, because in the next video, I will start with the rise of British in North India. The South India and British, South India, how the British expanded in South India,